Xander, TotalRock, Sunspear 2014. I'm with Sean from Shakespeare.
Hello.
Hello. How you doing?
I'm good, you?
Very well, yeah. It's been a few years since I've seen you now. I can't even remember when it was. It's probably about 3 years ago that I've last seen you. So what have you been up to in the last 3 years?
Touring. We released the second album as well. So yeah, to date we've done like 3 European tours, 3 US tours.
3 US tours?
Yeah,
wow.
Yeah. Yeah, we got out there quick,
yeah.
And yeah, released the second album. Here we are. Personally, do you want more about?
Well, you've been on TV as well.
No, we won't get into that.
Oh,
no, it's fine. You hear about on album 3.
Album 3?
Yeah.
How's it going?
Good. We haven't really. I mean, Mouth of Swords only came out in September last year.
Right.
So we're still running on that. We've done 3 tours with that. So we'll definitely. I mean, we're writing new material. Always. Sort of writing new material, so hopefully that'll be out next year.
Okay.
Early next year, maybe.
Nice.
We've always got stuff that we're quite keen to release. It almost feels like in a band, the minute you've released something, it feels old because you probably did record it 6 months before. So you're like, right, let's write something else.
Yeah.
But
okay. So you say you're always writing. You don't have breaks when you're touring. Is it you still come up with stuff whilst you're on tour as well?
Yeah. I mean, Des is the main songwriter. And he's always writing stuff and lyrically myself as well, and with melodies, always continuously sort of writing. It's just wherever it comes along.
Yeah.
Touring, I find, is not an inspirational place, bizarrely. No.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't know why. You're just thinking about, where am I going to crap next? Where's good to eat? Is there any good coffee? And how's the show going to go?
Yeah.
So in between that, you're like, ah. And now I'm drunk, so there's no time for inspiration.
No. Okay, then. So this weekend, are you here all weekend?
We only arrived today.
Ah, okay.
And I'm umming and ahhing about whether I'm going to stay or not.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know.
Don't
but
take
who
fancy?
Knows? Actually, tomorrow there are quite a few bands that I do want to see.
Yeah.
We'd like to see Carnival. I've seen them quite a few times, but, you know, they are a great band. Today I'm really looking forward to 100 Reasons.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
There were bands that, when we were all sort of, you know, 15, 16, we were really into 100 Reasons, yeah. Hell is for Heroes as well.
Yeah.
Remember seeing two of them play at Heatham House, I think, in Twickenham.
Okay. They did a Reformation gig together as well, didn't they?
Yeah, I missed that.
I did too. We were also with Cable as well.
Yeah.
That gig.
But really looking forward to seeing them. So
yeah, there was a point probably about 10 years ago they were just playing everywhere. They're on every tour, every
yes.
festival. You
yeah.
get away from them.
Yeah,
everyone's getting sick and tired.
Yeah, good. See them back. Hopefully they'll do some new material.
Well, yeah, we shall see. Okay, so apart from the album and touring, what else are you doing?
Well, we're touring with kind of doing some acoustic stuff.
Okay.
Recorded a few acoustic tracks. I'm not really sure if we'll release them or not, because it's kind of a different side of what we do, because we have the quite, you know, intense, quite technical parts of our songs, but then also the more laid back sort of parts of the songs, where it's, you know, clean vocals and quite chilled, lush guitars. So we're toying with that as well. And on our last album we actually had a song that was, you know, there's no screaming on it, and it could very well just be an acoustic song. So
that could work.
Yeah.
Yeah, Tesseract have done it.
Yeah, yeah, they have. And it's good to explore that other side as well.
Yeah. I was talking to Devin earlier, talking about it's a nice balance to have something at the opposite to one extreme, to have another one to balance it out.
Yeah, I mean, he did it by just doing whole albums, which were, you know, this album's heavy, this album's really light. Really great albums incorporate all of that, and as a writer you're trying to find that balance, but yeah. Sometimes you need to explore them separately until you really like hit on it of what is a good element of both.
Yeah. Okay, and do you find that fun exploring it?
Yeah, I mean, I'm before I even started in State of Fire, I was I didn't scream at all, I didn't do any metal stuff. It was very like, I do a lot of folk as well. My family were all Irish, so been from an Irish family, that's how I started singing, which was doing old traditional Irish songs, and everyone sings a song. So I do, I've got, my background's actually folk and acoustic, so it's quite nice to return back to that as well.
Okay.
Then you also at the same time be like, oh wait, I don't really need to do this really loud. Okay, calm the fuck down.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I remember first time I interviewed you talking about your influences as a metal vocalist, and you were saying, I'm teaching myself to do it, and obviously it's certainly the second album, you can see how your voice has progressed and got stronger as well.
Yeah.
You're finding your voice as well.
I think there's you're in danger of just sort of regurgitating what's already been done if you're not approaching it with a variety of influences. I think that's what, as a band, we've kind of done. And sometimes you hit it, sometimes you don't. People get it, sometimes they don't. Yeah, it's like, it's easier to fall within preconceived parameters of what people like.
But, try and please them rather than...
But it's more interesting to try and be like, well, fuck it, let's try something new. You know, like, see how it goes. People hate it sometimes.
Yeah.
You either fall into, that's great, or that's terrible. So...
It's great in my opinion.
Well, thanks.
I liked it. It's interesting though, because you got, well, your own voice, as I said. Mm. Okay. Earlier on, I can't remember if it's this year or last year, you're on TV.
Oh, Eggheads,
yeah. And you know what I thought would be really fun to do is ask you the questions you got wrong.
Personally?
Yeah.
My questions?
Yeah.
Have I got three options?
Well, the thing is...
I think I do remember
I recorded
the
it.
Okay.
And I'd saved it.
Bring
it
on!
But I ran out of room on my hard drive. So I had to delete it the week before I came up with this idea.
Okay. Just ask me any other general knowledge questions. Or do you remember the original questions?
I can't remember. No. What was your specialist subject?
Literature.
Literature.
Okay. It's hard.
Yeah.
Yeah, really hard.
Did you do it at uni?
Yeah. There's a lot of books.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, but I know nothing about literature.
Good.
Okay.
General knowledge questions.
In lieu of a question that you got wrong, give us an interesting fact on literature.
How can I sum it up in one fact? An interesting fact on literature.
Well, literature based.
Literature based. That's really hard. I think some of my favourite writers.
Or a quote, a line, perhaps.
How about Shakespeare was bisexual?
Really?
Yeah, there you go. Wrote sonnets to men.
Yeah. Interesting. There we are. That's today's daily fact.
Now you're like, oh.
Yeah.
That shit he says all the time.
Interesting. Yeah. That maybe explains a bit from, which one was it? Midsummer Night's Dream. There's a bit of cross-dressing in that, isn't there?
Oh, it's raucous.
Yeah.
Cross-dressing. Women as men as women.
Yeah.
Look at it in a very different perspective.
And in those days, only men were actors. So it's men dressed up as women.
Yeah.
And then in the parts where it's men pretending to be women, it's a man dressed up as a woman pretending to be a man. And that's confusing.
Exactly.
Imagine seeing that.
Yeah, it's why Britain's got such a good tradition of like dressing up as women.
Yeah.
It's just bizarre. But on another note, yeah, that's my next side project actually, doing starring as Hedwig from Hedwig and the Angry Inch. You know that film?
Oh well,
you'll find about it soon enough.
Okay.
Yeah.
Actual project.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where's this? Where are you doing this?
Oh, It's later on in the year. It's part of the London...
And this is theatre?
Fringe Film Festival. Musical.
Musical?
Yeah.
Really? Ooh. Interesting.
So we'll see more about that later on in the year. But
Should be awesome. Ah, I'd like to see that.
Cool.
That'd be interesting. Nice. Cool. John, thank you very much.
Cheers, man.
Enjoy the rest of the festival.
Thank you very much.